45-yard par 4. 5 today, 13 on, 11 from their left. It's coming out of the right roof. It's missed a bunch of fairways so far today. That is short and left, that might be in a bunker. Second side and a chance at a little qualifying spot, if not a playoff. This is a lengthy par putt here at 10, just to stay at 5 over par. First bogey of the day. He's had three double bogeys. Just a lone birdie at the ninth. Third toughest hole of the tenth last year in a qualifier, averaging 4.6. Jacob for bogey at 10. Just to fall back to 6 over. With 8 to go. First bogey, and he's back to plus 6. 7 from the right. Do not want to go long. Second shot for Jacob Hatter at 500-yard par 5, 14th. He's parred his last three holes, but he needs some birdies. As he is still 6 over par, with about 4.5 holes to go. He's running out of time. 15 is not an easy hole, neither is 17. Great shots at 18 just to try to set up a birdie on that par 5. It's the second fairway bunker he has found in three holes, both out to the right. And his third shot close at 12, probably the closest he's been to the hole all day. just ran that birdie putt well past the hole. Cannot afford any more drop shots. Already six over, but four holes left. So it'll be tough to try to make up six shots in four holes. I guess he's going to have to find two birdies and two eagles. And two of the last four holes are not easy to birdie. Misses this putt, and no chance. Let's see, would then be seven over. Nope, he's made it, so six over. He's going to need to finish fast and furiously to have a chance. You'll probably need to be even par. Well, somewhere down the hill is Jacob Hatter. At the 400 yard par 415th. It's part his last four holes in a row, but he doesn't need pars, he needs birdies. And don't tell me he's in trouble again. Already found the penalty area earlier today off the tee at number four. That led to his second of three double bogeys on his scorecard today. Left at one, chipped out, got on in three putted for six there, and then at five, I believe he was in the fairway off the tee, then put his second shot in the greenside bunker, got out, and three putted again for a six, and he bogeyed 10 to going long again after his third shot out of the greenside bunker. And I guess that's his mom walking down the hill. So he must have some issues again. He hasn't hit a lot of fairways today. He's pinned at 15 today, 13 on and 4 from their left. Jacob now, but where did his tee shot finish? There are two fairway bunkers on the left side, unless he came up short of them. And Tyler Lipscomb looked like he had some issues earlier at this hole. Finding Lowell Water Creek. So the two playing partners have hit their second shots pretty close to the hole. But Jacob, unfortunately, the only one to miss the fairway. There's Jacob. Oh, he hit the green. Sit. All in all, not a bad shot. Got over that false front. Birdie putt for Jacob. To make this to have a chance. And then maybe think about trying to hold out a second shot on the next. And maybe hold out for an eagle at 18 as well. As well as birdie 17. And I think his chances of getting into the tournament this year have fallen by the wayside again. Three holes eagles left. Jacob will have the eagle, all three of them coming in. And he'll have the ace, the par 3, 17th. As well as eagle 16 and 18, just get it back to even par and shoot 72. Today for Jacob, and that was at the par 5 and 9th. It was year in and year out that the Dogwood Invitational plays as the easiest hole at Druid Hills. One under on par 5, so today's par 7 and 14. There's one par 5 left. Five straight pars. Jacob needs at this point. Sure, it beats bogeys and double bogeys, but given his current score, he needs birdies. Second shot for Hatter at 16. I believe the flag is on 15 and 5 from their right. This was the third easiest hole last year in the qualifier. And that is Jacob's best shot of the day. What? Hate to say it, but I think it's a little too little, too late. Because he is plus 6. That would only give him the plus 5. And even if he buries the last two holes, it's probably not going to be enough for a playoff unless the whole field struggles. Right, live greenside at 16. Jacob Hatter. Only his second birdie of the round. This is here at the short par 4. It's the last par 4 for these guys today. It's a 3-5 finish coming up. Just to move Jacob back to plus 5, which is where he made the turn at. So he would be even on this second nine. Had three double bogeys in his first five holes today. He birdied 9 and he bogeyed 10. He's had all pars ever since. Until now. Birdie number 2 for Jacob. You know, Justin Matthies birdied the same two holes in his round of 78 3 years ago. In the qualifier. Two holes left for this group. is if you go to Druid Hills Clubhouse, just come back to the side to 18 and to the power. Timber. But not kind of day off the tee for Jacob. At least a par to shoot 77, 30 from 76. Second hole. Towards the lower practice green. Nope, there's the leaderboard. Third year in a row that Dogwood has provided an actual leaderboard. Jacob's fourth shot. Pin today at 18 is 9 on 6 from the right. Up and down for par and around 77. Bogey will get him around 78. He's really struggled off the tees today. He's only hit a handful of fairways. Closed with a double bogey here last year to shoot 80. I wonder if that's still in the back of his mind. He dropped in the cart path earlier. Now a sprinkler head in the way. Two drops in this hole. There's a piece on the right side of the green, but that'll be a lengthy par putt for Jacob. That'll be from 77. Have it for par in the round of 77, 5 over. Three shots better than the score from last year.